This video is brought to you by Fabulous. Faster, cheaper, greener. 3D printing may reshape the world canvas for good, or at least on paper, like all wonderful inventions, it's been hyped up over the last few years. But what if I told you that Italian architects designed the world's first 3D printed house out of dirt? Yes, dirt. Now clearly the hype hasn't bitten the dust yet, so let's take a closer look at what this means for the future of building sustainable homes, and if they're all that they're cracked up to be. I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. I'll get to the dirty house in just a minute, which isn't exactly a compelling sales pitch, is it? Anyway, before I get to that, let's quickly wrap our print heads around what 3D printing even is. A very quick recap, since the Japanese lawyer Hideo Kodama developed rapid prototyping, a lot of ink has been spilled. After years of technological advancements, selective laser sintering and fused deposition modeling are now the state-of-the-art 3D printing techniques. Regardless of the method of the raw material that you use, the general principle is roughly the same. Based on a sketch, the 3D printing machine uses the so-called additive manufacturing process to create the real object in a multi-layer manner. As for SLS, the 3D printer solidifies a photosensitive powdered polymer by hitting it with a powerful laser light. FDM-based machines melt thermoplastic polymers that become solid once it cools. That's how the very first 3D printed house was created in 2014. In that case, designers mostly fed bioplastic to the printer. After that, many other 3D printed homes have joined the printing queue. If you want to get more details on that, you can find a link to my previous video in the description. Now it's time to dish the dirt on the Italian 3D printed clay-made house. Mario Cucinella Architects came up with an original 3D printing concept. Well, they copied it from the mason wasps, to be honest, but I guess insects can't sue you for violating a patent. The Italian architects crafted a beehive-like structure out of locally sourced clay. To do so, MCA used a 3D printing technology developed by a company called Wasp. I know, they're not buzzing with originality. Jokes aside, how does that work? Well, Wasp developed a software package that allowed the simultaneous control and operation of two printing arms. The company claims this software is the first of its kind anywhere in the world. After mixing raw earth from that location with water, the two 3D printers squirt out 350 layers of clay in a wave-like manner to ensure structural stability. They also use rice waste in the goop to increase the insulating properties. When it's complete, you have two interconnected dome-shaped units, including an open space living room and an ensuite bedroom. On top of that, Wasp machines can print furniture like tables and chairs as well. And creating a cupola was a smart choice as it lets you build walls and roof in one go. Also, the 3D printers spit out domes one section at a time. Now, while limited to one floor only, this modular approach makes the habitat horizontally scalable. The group named their method Tekla, linking technology and clay. The idea is that by building this house, no waste is generated, and at the end of its life, it fades away into the ground without making a trace. It makes sense when you consider that 3D printing minimizes construction waste, and that you can make clay easily disappear. And it's massive in terms of emission reduction compared to other 3D printed homes built out of concrete or plastic. Not to mention that using on-site raw earth, you completely remove the emissions related to transporting building materials from elsewhere. The project partners envision the two cupola dwelling as a self-sustaining hub. Besides the earth-friendly walls, Tekla is surrounded by sustainability. Outside, you have a little lake collecting rain and gray water, and this goes through a phytodeprivation process before flowing inside the house. Aiming to make an off-grid unit, designers included a dedicated structure provided with solar panels that generate clean energy. The Tekla creators wanted to take this idea global, so Wasp put together a kit to assemble the whole infrastructure, and they can ship it around the world in a container. So what about the cost? While the startup hasn't disclosed Tekla's price tag yet, it did spend around $1,000 to print 30 meters of wall for their first 3D printed home in 2018. Just like clay, you could model Tekla to adapt it to different climates, and you could use a wide range of locally available natural building materials. Thanks to its flexible and climate resilient architecture, Tekla could tackle the global housing crisis. According to Cucinella, this type of dwelling would make the most sense in isolated rural areas where construction materials are difficult to obtain. Dwellings could be built in just about anywhere, assuming that the self-production kit can be delivered there. And before you get too excited about living in a clay house, let's dig into this a little bit. Tekla walls can be 3D printed in about 8 days. However, clay doesn't dry as fast as quick-drying concrete. It can take weeks to dry in the most humid regions. Speaking of timelines, be wary of whoever fawns over promising you to deliver a 3D printed house within 24 hours. I learned this the hard way. In my previous video, I mentioned a Chinese company 3D printed 10 houses in 24 hours. To accomplish this feat, they used 4 machines, not one. And also, the 24-hour window doesn't include the time to install windows and all the other components. It's just the walls. Same story for 3D printed dwellings that hosted human beings for the first time. The French studio 3D printers built the main skeleton of the house in 54 hours. But again, it took 4 more months for workers to place windows, doors, roof, and appliances by hand. Remember the $1,000 figure mentioned earlier? That's covering just the walls of Wasp's 3D printed creation. However, when you look at the Fibonacci house recently 3D printed in Canada, walls accounted for only 6% of the overall outlay. Tekla's still in its early stages and needs to go through structural and thermal testing before it's scaled up, so it's tricky to have an accurate price at the moment. In fact, as mentioned by Cobod's CEO, you need to 3D print at least 10 houses to provide more reliable estimates. 3D printed houses are often advertised as the cheapest option on the market, with a low-cost claim is based on what you save in terms of raw materials and labor. However, these costs change around the world, so 3D printed houses will be cheaper in some countries compared to others. And things get even more muddy when you get some bad press, or too good to be true press, I should say. Respectable publications reported that Icon would have 3D printed a house for as low as $4,000. However, when interviewed by the YouTuber Jarrett Gross, Icon's founder labeled that figure as a mishap. Nobody from the company team ever leaked that quote to any journalist. Instead, $450,000 is the more realistic price that Icon put on a housing complex developed in Texas, which I covered in my previous video on 3D printed homes. This is below the average price of a standard house in that area. Yet the company 3D printed only the first floor, while they used stick framing for building the upper level. You may see why this $450,000 is an underestimated figure. And keep in mind that this is the first home on the market, so don't take that price as gospel. The next point, surely a house made of dirt must be green, right? Well, while being touted as a zero waste paradise, Tekla actually isn't. Like any other 3D printed house, it's got its feet of clay. That's because Wasp's 3D printers can't gush out the finishings, plumbing, electrical, wiring, and all the other household appliances out of clay yet. Now, some components must be finished after 3D printing is completed. They envisioned their housing system as part of a low-density eco-city. Ironically, this sprawling effect comes at an environmental cost. For instance, inking the natural landscape with fragmented human settlements gets in the way of wildlife. Living remotely requires transportation, which means added air pollution unless you can afford an electric vehicle with long range. On the other hand, your emissions get lower in denser cities. People living in Toronto's low-density suburbs emit up to 2.5 times more greenhouse gases than the high-density urban residents. Another study found that doubling US cities' density would drive down travel emissions by 50%. How about Tekla's social impact? Well, we would need a lot of clay. As of 2005, the United Nations counted 100 million people homeless around the world, and 1.6 billion live in poor state houses, which will be 3 billion by 2030, according to the UN Habitat. Just put that in perspective, this is nearly half the world's population. To alleviate the housing crisis, we're pressed for time and we'd need to churn out 96,000 affordable homes every day. That's what I call a long printing queue. Now, even if Wasp nozzles were to go full blast, we need to read the small print carefully. Let's pick a country like Kenya, for instance. Nicholas Patel, who runs a construction company in Kenya, turned down the hype on the feasibility of 3D printing housing in the African continent. First, you need to factor in the carbon footprint and cost of shipping Wasp kit all the way to Africa. Then you'd have a lot of local challenges, such as lacking or poor infrastructure, legal issues, and the need for security 24/7. Looking at the bigger 3D printed picture, 3D printing may have a negative impact on countries having a lot of low-paid construction workers. Because of its potential in reducing waste and emissions, 3D printing could play a key role in the decarbonization of the construction industry. On top of that, this automated building process could knock down execution time and expenses. Even with these advantages, though, the technology is still in its infancy and cost reduction expectations are still to be confirmed. Tekla is clearly one of the most sustainable and versatile 3D printed houses on Earth so far, but it's still a long way to go before 3D printers could produce affordable and truly zero-waste homes. There's many baby steps involved in bringing new technologies like this to market. And speaking of taking one step at a time, little baby steps, I don't know about you, but I have a hard time finding a good work-life balance and building healthier habits. Producing these videos kind of consumes every waking hour of my life, so I've been trying to get better about being productive, but being mindful of my downtime. And that's where today's sponsor, Fabulous, comes in. What really appealed to me about Fabulous was their scientific approach to developing healthy habits and daily routines tailored to me, and how well I'm actually sticking with it. It's completely customized based on behavioral science, and it breaks down scientifically proven healthy habits into very small tasks that you can easily achieve every single day. You pick what you want to focus on, and for me that was mindfulness and mental health, but I could have easily said sleep. Each journey helps you to reach your objective by gamifying it and coaching you along the way. Since I started using Fabulous, I've gotten much better about my morning and afternoon routines, which helps to give me a chance to decompress and recenter myself. It's been helping me to reduce my daily stress. And because I've got a premium membership, I'm about to start my journey on improving my sleep, and boy do I need it. Start building your ideal routine today. The first 500 people to click on the link get 25% off a Fabulous subscription. Link in the description below, and thanks to Fabulous and to all of you for supporting the channel. So what do you think of 3D printing and construction like this? Jump in the comments and let me know. And if you have knowledge of this, or if you work in the industry, please share your experience so we can learn together. You can also join my Discord server and talk to other members of the community. I've also got the link in the description. And thanks as always to my patrons, and a big welcome to new producers Raymond Poe and Herman. All of your direct support really helped with producing these videos and to reduce my dependence on the almighty YouTube algorithm. Speaking of which, if you like this video, be sure to check out one of the ones I've linked to right here, and subscribe and hit that notification bell if you think I've earned it. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.